Shout loud, hallelujah. Shout to Jericho destroying, hallelujah. Let's rise up on our feet, please. As we close our eyes and pray for ourselves with this song loud and clear. Holy Ghost, dream again, again. Thank you. me not so gentle, say, in your my humble heart. Why on earth as thou art holy, you not pass me. Savior, 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 Savior. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, I love you. How I love, how I love. Made impossibility possible. You made impossibility possible. Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Rapha. Hallelujah. He made impossibility possible. He made impossibility possible.
Raise up your right hand to the heavens, beloved. Oh, thou that troubleth my Israel, my God shall trouble you tonight. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Our Lord and our God, the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the one who understands all things, who knows all things, and who can do all things, we give you praise. Accept our thanks in Jesus' name. Tonight, wonderful God, we are gathered unto you. Meet every one of us here. Lay your hands upon our lives. Open our understanding. And by the time we finish today's meeting, let men and women see your glory upon our lives. In Jesus' name we pray. Let's have a seat. God bless you. Praise the Lord. Tonight, by the grace of God, I would like you to be very, very attentive to the few words I'm going to speak from here. And to the prayers we're going to pray thereafter. I want you to know that nobody comes to the mountain of fire and miracles ministry by chance. If you are here, it's because God wants you to be here. So I'd like you to listen to me very, listen to this short message very carefully and then pray the prayers thereafter. For a few minutes, we're going to look at what I call locate your location. Locate your location. Sisters, what did I say? Yeah. And brothers? Yeah. I will take us into some scriptures straight away. In Jeremiah chapter 18, I'm reading verse 2. But let me take it from verse 1. Jeremiah 18 from verse 1. The word which came to Jeremiah from the Lord, saying, arise, and go down to the potter's house. And there, in the potter's house, I will cause thee to hear my words. Please note that very carefully. Why did God not talk to Jeremiah in his house? He said, no, get away from that place. Go down to the potter's house. When you get there, then you will hear. Location. In 1 Kings chapter 17, 1 Kings chapter 17, from verse 8. 1 Kings 17, from verse 8. And the word of the Lord came unto him, saying, arise, get thee to Zarephath, which belongeth to Sidon, and dwell there. Behold, I've commanded a widow woman there to sustain thee. Again, location. In Numbers chapter 23, Numbers 23 verse 15, Numbers 23, 15. And he said unto Balak, stand here by thy burnt offering, while I meet the Lord yonder. While I meet the Lord yonder. That is, the place of the burnt offering of that king was not the place to hear God. He said, I'm going yonder. I'm going to another location, he said. In Luke chapter 24, verse 49. Luke 24, verse 49. Locate your location. Luke 24, 49. This is Jesus speaking. And behold, I send the promise of my Father upon you. But, tarry ye in the city of where? Jerusalem. Until ye be endued with power from on high. Again, location. So much for that. We're going back to more scriptures later. The mystery of location has a high significance to God and to the devils. Location has a very high significance to God and to devils. This is why it has been well said that 99% of success is correct location. Once the enemy removes you from your correct location, the person is as good as finished. The cry that God cried against Adam in the garden, at Adam, where art thou? Is a lamentation of wrong location. There is a place, a position, spiritually and physically, that Adam was meant to be. But God looked at the position, the location where he normally found Adam and where he placed Adam. But he didn't find him there anymore. So Adam was physically before God. God could see him physically. But he has changed location. And so God himself had to lament. Say, Adam, where art thou? Why have you changed your location? Why are you not in the position where I can bless you? Beloved, the truth is this. There are some messages that God will never pass on to some persons until they have changed locations. There are some words that can never be received from God because the people have not moved to the place designated for that declaration. For example, why did Jesus say, tarry ye in Jerusalem? Why was Jerusalem the forwarding address? For example, in the case of Jeremiah, why did God not say what he wanted to say in Jeremiah's house? Why did he say he had to go to the potter's house? There are some spiritual experiences that are tied to particular places and particular locations. What do you think may have happened to Prophet Elijah if he had chosen to remain at the brook of Cherith when God says, go to Zarephath? especially in the chariot where he was, the ravens were feeding him conveniently there. If he refused to move, his next blessing will have gone to his next forwarding address. It will have gone to his location for his subsequent miracles. But since he himself refused to move, he will lose that miracle. There are some promises, some messages, some spiritual experiences. There are some blessings which you have to be in some specific location at some specific times in order to get it. Many years ago in our church in those days, there used to be this hard-working woman. Every day it was first in the service. We clean the benches, sweep the floor, clean the surroundings. She was there every day. Immediately the doors are opened, she got in and started work. Her life was upside down. Nothing was working for her, and she kept coming. She kept doing the work. In those days, we used to have morning service at 5 a.m. By 6:37, the service has closed, and people go to work from church. Beloved, life used to be a lot better then. This woman was coming every evening service, morning service, she was there. One particular morning, as she rose up to come to church, the devil also woke up with her and said, "Where are you going? Every day you have been going. What did you bring back? You are sweeping the floor, cleaning benches for the mates of your children. Husband, you don't have children, you don't have anything. And you're just going there to waste your time to sweep. Come on, sit at home today and cry." She sat at home. Unfortunately, that was the day his angel of blessing came. The angel came to the service and waited for her to arrive. As the service was about to close, there was a prophecy. And the prophecy was a lamentation. That, "Where is my daughter Dorcas today, when I'm here to bless her? So unfortunately she's not here. And as it is written, that the words that have gone forth from my mouth shall not come back to me void." Say, "We have to give it to somebody else." Close your eyes, beloved. Any power that will relocate me from my place of blessing, what are you waiting for? Die! In the name of Jesus. Masakapora da Santayaba. Ribosoponde Kayabo Shentelaba Kayaba. Any power that will relocate me from my place of blessings. Your time is up, your time is up. Masikayabo Shentayabo Koraba. Any power that will relocate you from my place of blessing. Masikateya boshenteraba. Open your mouth and declare it, beloved. You are not here to play. We are here for serious business. In Jesus' name we pray. Let's continue a little bit further, beloved. A few years later, we went to bury Sister Dorcas. No husband, nothing. All because one day she missed her location. In Genesis chapter 12, from verse 1, we call Abraham our father. We call him the father of faith. And we sing Abraham's blessings are mine. Abraham, blessings are mine. I'm blessed in the morning, in the noon, in the evening. Abraham, blessings are mine. Let us see the origin of the blessing of Abraham. Genesis chapter 12, verse 1. "Now the Lord has said unto Abraham, get thee out of thy country, and from thy kindred, and from thy father's house." He must get out of three things. "Unto a land that I will show thee." After he has complied with those instructions, then came the sevenfold blessings of Abraham. "And I will make of thee a great nation. I will bless thee and make thy name great. and thou shalt be a blessing. And I will bless them that bless thee, and curse them that curse thee, and in thee shall all families of the earth be blessed. What happened in verse 4? So Abraham departed, as the Lord had spoken unto him, and Lot went with him. And Abraham was 75 years old when he departed out of Haran. And Abraham took Sarah his wife and Lot his brother's son, and all their substance that they had gathered, and the souls they had gotten in Haran. And they went forth to go into the land of Canaan. And into the land of Canaan they came. And Abraham passed through the land unto the place of Shechem, unto the plain of Moreh. And the Canaanite was then in the land. Abraham was going to be blessed, but only after he had located his location. He had to get out of his father's house. A man will not enter his possession if he's yet to obey the instruction to depart from his father's house and to report into his land of promise. This is why you see us praying here about how every part of my father's house, my father's house, my father's house. If you are an African, know for sure that the powers of your father's house are not powers of favor, unless all your generational line have all been born again Christians. But if they are not, you need to relocate yourself from that house and locate yourself into your land of promise. Many people are still dwelling in their father's house spiritually, and they are not well located yet to be blessed. You need to locate your location. There was a time Prophet Elijah ran, but what did God tell him? In 1 Kings 19, verse 9. And he came thither unto a cave, and lodged there. And behold, the word of the Lord came to him, and he said unto him, what doest thou here? Here, Elijah. Verse 13 again. And it was so when Elijah heard it, that he wrapped his face in his mantle, and went out and stood at the entrance of the cave. And behold, there came a voice unto him, and said again, what doest thou here, Elijah? The question was not, what doest thou, Elijah? No. If that was the question, that would have been asking about his activity there. But what doest thou here? Here, this location. So God was specifically addressing location and was telling him that this is a wrong location, Elijah. You need to get out of this place. Many of us are doing businesses that we need to depart from quick. Any business you are doing and you have to tell lies every day, you better depart. You call yourself hairdresser, saloonist. The first head that came in the morning was the head of a witch. So you spend your hand rubbing that head all over the place. The next head that came from the waters. You use your head rubbing that one too. The third head that came in was a fake prophetess. And you use your hand to rub that head too. And then you use the same head to rub your body. The same hand to rub your body. The same hand to eat. Of course, you pollute yourself gradually. Gradually. You need to relocate to your land of blessing. Whatever you are doing, and you have to tell lies to sustain it, is a wrong location. Whatever man wants to marry you, and any time you are in the presence of the man, he has never been interested in Bible study. He's not interested in prayer. He's not interested in, let us pray about our relationship. All the time you are there, it's to kiss your face, to kiss your hand, to kiss your leg. You better relocate. In the wrong location. A man can never do the right thing in the wrong place. A man can never perform his duty in a place other than his divine duty post. God was telling Elijah, this is not your duty post. Go to where you are supposed to be. Is God interested in where we live? Oh yes. A place could be Jerusalem. Yet, if God has not sent a person there, the person will be in trouble. Failure to receive your portion in life could be because you did not move to your God appointed location. Look at Jesus in Mark chapter 8. What I'm telling you this evening, they are very serious matters. The matter that the prayer does not stop here, that you need to continue praying at home. In Mark chapter 8, verse 22, they brought somebody to Jesus. Mark 8, 22. And he cometh to Bethsaida, and they bring a blind man unto him, and besought him to touch him. What did Jesus do? And he took the blind man by the hand, and led him out of the town. He led him out of that location. That place that the blind man was not his land of healing. And when he had spit on his eyes, he put his hands upon him. He asked him if he saw hot. And he looked up and said, I see men as trees walking. And after that, he put his hands again upon his eyes and made him look up. And he was restored and saw every man clearly. The bondage of that man was so serious, Jesus had to touch the place twice. But before Jesus could even do that, he had to bring him out of that town. So miracles sometimes then may have a place to do with a designated place. Say your divine contact address and expect to receive your divine letters. Because the angels of God will only go to your contact address. Can a man say, because I'm a prophet, I can live anywhere? No. Is God interested in where we live or choose to move to? Yes. If you want to rent a house, you want to buy a land, you want to build a house, you first of all have to ask God whether you should go there. Because something like that originally looks like Garden of Eden can sometimes become Sodom and Gomorrah. It could become a garden of death. Jonah and Lot learned their lessons the wrong way. Lot pointed to a location. It was Sodom and Gomorrah. Jonah refused to go to his location, and there was terrible trouble. What are the symptoms of a wrong location? When you are wrongly located, what signs do you see? Distress. Barriers. Hardening of bondages, horrible dreams, success of satanic attacks. When the enemy just comes to your bedroom easily and go in and do what they want to you. Sometimes you cry, Jesus! But you need to cry several times before they leave you alone. Location. Consistent bad luck. Failure of divine purpose on somebody's life. These are marks that you are wrongly located. Chronic poverty, unexplainable hair loss, gradual loss of property, unexplainable examination and interview failures, wrong partners, wrong friends. Once you begin to notice those symptoms, you need to cry out to the heavenlies that if I'm wrongly located, oh God, relocate me to the right position. That is what is known, beloved, as satanic relocation. That is, the devil will manipulate and push a person away from his place of blessing. And the enemy has many anti-divine location strategies. Sometimes what you call the power of darkness is really not the power of darkness. It's just evil wisdom. They take a person away from where they know his divine contact address is. They know that as far as you are not in the correct place where God wants you to be, nothing will happen to you. Then they start attacking the person. And when you cry out in that position, instead of God to say, okay, I'm coming to deliver you, rather God will say, what doest thou there? What are you doing there? That will be the question God will be asking. We can create a situation where it will appear as if the hands of God are too short to save. The enemy has many devices to relocate a person. I will now go through them one by one before we start praying. Number one, anti-divine location strategy. Provision of good but wrong alternatives. It's good, but it's not the right one. The fact that something is a good idea doesn't mean it's God's idea for you. I want you to understand this very, very well. Good. The enemy gives the person a good alternative, but it's a wrong alternative. Number two, the enemy will give a person wrong success. The person will be having AA and will be passing all the wrong subjects. He will be succeeding in the wrong things. What will destroy him is what he will be doing so well at. Wrong success. Number three is diversion friends. Friends who will mislead you. Many people don't have any good friend. Four. This one is very common now. Foreign visa lotteries. Somebody is meant to be blessed in his country. He will go and play visa, and the enemy will make sure you win and you relocate. He goes there and suffering begins. I remember that friend of my daddy that went abroad, and when he wanted to start work, yeah, I was a man who has a good job in Nigeria. When he got there, they asked him, can you work here? He said, oh yes. You are very sure? He said, oh yes. So some Nigerians also took him there to work. They didn't tell him the kind of work it was going to be. When they got there, the man now discovered that the job was to wash corpses. When they opened the mortuary for the man, and he saw these corpses of white people, he fainted. And immediately he fainted, they sacked him and sacked all the other Nigerians. And so the other Nigerians now began to fight him. We told you before that if you can't do it, say you can't do it. God will help us. Number five, impatience. That is, you are trying to run faster than God. Running faster than God. Impatience. Six, spiritual blindness. Seven, pride. Pride will have destroyed Naaman, who wanted to teach God where to be located. Eight is foundational bondage. Bondages in the foundation can specialize in positioning a person for failure. Nine, household wickedness. Ten, living in sin. 11, fear. And 12, dream, vision, and prophecy manipulation. Some people will be seeing the wrong revelation, wrong vision, wrong dreams. And they'll be following those dreams and visions, thereby missing their way. Beloved, it is a tragedy for your angel of blessing to arrive to look for you and he could not locate you where he should locate you. That's why we need to pray from the bottom of our heart that any power that is pushing us away from our appointed location should be dismantled. There is something called receiving unwanted load. The principle of receiving unwanted load is wrong location. There is something the Bible calls showers of blessing. The principle of showers of blessing is divine location. What are we going to do? The first thing to do for somebody who wants to be correctly located all the time is to seek the face of God. Seek the face of God. Two, pray inquiry prayers. That, oh Lord, am I doing the wrong thing? Oh Lord, am I in the correct spiritual temperature? Three, you need to receive deliverance from the evil relocation agent. Just relocate people to where they will not be blessed. Then the next thing you should do is to pray rescheduling prayers, relocation prayers. And the Lord should cause you to go back to where you should go back to. When you locate your location, your destiny will locate you. When a person is supposed to get to a particular level and you are not there, that means you are still not in your location. Your angel of blessing may wait for you there. And if he doesn't find you, he could go back. Tonight, we have some serious prayers to pray because there is a purpose for this message. Rise up on your feet, beloved. All eyes closed. Please see, if you are here tonight, and you are not born again, you have not just surrendered your life to Jesus, do so very, very quickly. So wherever you are, while all eyes are closed, say, man of God, I want to surrender my life to Jesus. Just raise up your right hand where you are and say what I'm going to say after me. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I come before you now. Lord Jesus, come into my life. Take control of my life. In Jesus' name, amen. If you said that short prayer with me, immediately we'll close. Just find a way to the front here so that we can pray more with you. Now listen very carefully, beloved. Any power that is dragging a person to where his angels will not locate him is a wicked power. Those who pray that, oh Lord, let me be in the right place at the right time, is a very powerful prayer. Listen, beloved, even as we are gathered here this evening, there is a multiple array of hosts of heavens here. We are not here to joke at all. If you see somebody joking with these prayers by your side, just leave the person and go and stand somewhere else. There are thousands and thousands here tonight who will be blessed by praying these prayers. The first prayer I want you to cry to the heavens with all the strength you have is this. Just in case there are blessings that have come to look for you in the church before and you didn't come that day. The particular day of that blessing, you didn't come. You were absent. So it was return to heaven. Those are the first areas we want to deal with very quickly now. Fortunately, there is something called the mercy of God. Under the canopy of that mercy, those blessings can still be brought back. You open your mouth and pray this like fire and like thunder. Every blessing that belongs to me, but has gone back to heaven. Can I hear the sister saying what I said just now? Is that the best the sisters can do here tonight? Brothers, can I hear you shouting it louder than sisters? Everybody together now! Come back! In the name of Jesus! Masikaya Boshenta. Yes! Open your mouth, open your mouth. Don't be afraid. Masikateya Boshenta Rabakayaba. Yes. Aha! Aha! Look at what is happening! Look at what is happening! Masikaya Boshentera Bokola Baraba. Yes, the blessings that belong to me that has gone back. Come down! 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 Yes! Continue. Continue. Tonight is tonight. Continue. 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 Masikaya Boshentera Bokopola Basanta. Nario Bokopanda Satayabaka. Matarabo Sotoya Bokoshente Yaba. Yes. 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 In Jesus' name we pray. I see things coming down, coming down. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You will now shout this louder than anyone close to you. I receive them. In the name of Jesus. Yes, receive them.
in the name of Jesus. I receive them 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 in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Those things are still dropping down. They are still dropping. Amen. I see it dropping down. Many things dropping. 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 Yes. Dropping. Masikatenda yabo kushente raba. Ribosapia. Likatenda rabo santa. Yes, they're dropping. Dropping. Amen. Now listen. Now go to the very serious, very serious level. Very serious level. Balaam told Balak, they stay here by your burnt offering, but I will go yonder so I can talk to God. Location. Location. He will say this loud and clear. Every power of my father's are pushing me away from my divine appointment. Pushing me away from my divine appointment. Down in the name of Jesus. Every power of my father's house pushing me away from my place of divine appointment. Your time is up. Your time is up. Yes. Masafokaya bo shantara bo korabasanda. Ribosaponda kaya bo shantara pakada. Yes, 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 yes. Yes. Masikateya bo shantara bo korabaraba. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Aha! Does it? Does it? Every power of my father's house pushing me away from my place of divine appointment. Your time is up. Your time is up. Your time is up. Your time is up. In Jesus' name we pray. Silence now, beloved. There are so many people here tonight whose lives will no longer remain the same. Yes. Because even this very night, they are going to have a divine visitation. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Now listen. If you were born into the wrong location, you were raised in the wrong location. Unfortunately, you went to the wrong nursery school. You went to the wrong primary school. Then you took the wrong entrance examinations. Then you entered into the wrong secondary school where they taught you those things you are not supposed to do. You finished from there, you went to the wrong polytechnic, the wrong university. And all your life you have been in the wrong position. And now you want to be correctly positioned. It's not a gentleman's prayer. Bible says, right from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffered violence, and the violent taketh it by force. Oh God, Allah! and place me in my right location. In the name of Jesus. Oh God, arise. And place me in my right location. In the name of Jesus. Yes. Yes, 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 yes. In my right location. Bosekateya boshentera bokopora basanta. Naribo kapende kesepela bokoya boshanta. Daria bokosopende kaya boshanta. Rapapia di kasantiala. Place me in my right location. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Silence. That thing you said just now, I see reorganization taking place. I want you to think very well. If by divine appointment, by now you are supposed to be a landlord, but you are renting, then don't be too surprised if you get a quit notice. What is the reason? Wrong location. This is why you need to pray this very hard. Any power dragging me to where my angels of blessing will not locate me. Can you shout this loud and clear? Say it louder than that. What are you waiting for? Yeah! In the name of Jesus. Yes, say it, say it. Tonight is tonight. Don't negotiate. Masikate ya bosha. Ribo sopokote la baka ya boshenta. Boride ketende ke ya boshempe la bokora bosoto la ba. Maria kapende ke sete ya bokoshenta. In Jesus' name we pray. Beloved, because of what I see the Lord doing now, please take a song of praises in your mouth and sing it loud and clear to the King of Kings and to the Lord of Lords. Sing it loud and clear to the King of Kings and to the Lord of Lords. What a mighty God we serve. How great is our God. How great is his name. How great is his love. Forever the same. He rolled back the waters of the mighty Red Sea. And he said, I never leave. Put your trust in me. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. I'd like you to stretch your two hands forward. Stretch your two hands forward now. Like somebody ready to receive something special from the Lord. You will say this loud and clear. Chariots of fire. Clear the way. Every blockage in my heavens. Can you shout that loud and clear? In the name of Jesus, let the blockages be cleared away. In the name of Jesus, chariots of fire, clear away every blockage in my heavens. Every blockage in my heavens. Every blockage in my heavens. The sister in this meeting, you are from a polygamous home. The senior wife has programmed something into your right leg. As far as that thing is in that right leg, there cannot be any breakthrough. But right there where you are, the power of God is coming upon you, and that yoke upon that right leg is broken now. Thank you, Jesus. That leg is on fire now. You will say this again. My Father, if I have been diverted from my land of promise. Can you say that loud and clear? Relocate me by fire in the name of Jesus. Let there be a relocation by fire. In Jesus' name we pray. Let me tell you three things that will happen to some people here before the next palm must change. There are some people here, all the antagonists in their places of work are going to be sacked. There are also some people here that even before this coming palm must change, they will receive letters that will change their lives forever. To change their lives forever. There are also some people here, it's like you are going through a famine of favor, but that famine has been dried up tonight. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Let us share the grace in fellowship.